Hello, my name is Nikhil Arora and I'm a second year student of Engineering Physics at IIT Roorkee. Today I'll be presenting on the working and applications of the 7-segment display. So let me give you a brief introduction of what is a 7-segment display. So 7-segment display basically consists of 7 or 8 LED or LCD panels. It's an electronic display device. So it is a display device for displaying decimal numbers or certain ASCII characters, and it is an alternative to dot matrix displays or cold cathode neon tubes. There are also other examples like 14 segment displays and 16 segment displays for displaying full alphanumeric characters. This is the 14 segment display and this is a 16 segment display with two extra segments here. Now these segments may be LED panels or LCD panels depending on the use. So you can see these are the labeled segments A, B, C, D, E, F, G and the decimal point, and these are the diodes which are connected to each segment. So let's talk about the multiplexing and the types of displays. Essentially there are two types of displays. The difference between the two types are the common cathode type and the common anode type. The difference between the two displays, as the name suggests, is that the common cathode type has all the cathodes of the 7-segment displays connected directly together, and the common anode has all the anodes of the 7-segment display connected together. So the common cathode type is a common cathode display and all the cathodes are joined together to logic 0 or ground. The individual segments are illuminated by application of a high or logic 1 signal via current limiting resistor to forward bias the individual anode terminals. And the common anode type, all the anode connections of the LED segment are joined together to logic 1, and the individual segments are illuminated by applying a ground logic 0 or low signal via suitable current limiting resistor to the cathode of the particular segment. So we generally prefer the common anode type display, and they are more popular as they can source a high current. So depending, we'll be now talking about the biasing and the truth table. Depending upon the decimal digit to be displayed, the particular set of LEDs is forward biased. Like in this case, these particular diodes are forward biased. For instance, to display the numeric digit 0, we will need to light up 6 of the LED segments corresponding to A, B, C, D, E and F. Thus the various digits from 0 to 9 can be displayed using a 7-segment display as follows. So this would be the truth table for the same. For 0 we want A, B, C, D, E and F, and similarly for the others. Now the actual working of the display is like this. The 7 segments of the cathode or anode display are illuminated using the switches. If a switch is closed, current will obviously flow through the segment. So if A is closed, for example, current will flow through the segment to the current limiting resistor, through the current limiting resistor, and completing the circuit. Thus only A segment will be illuminated. So a low condition is required to activate it. So when we have a counter set to 0 for A, this LED will light up, and when it is set to 1, the switch will be broken and it will not light up. So these displays are usually driven by special type of integrating circuits, commonly known as 7-segment decoder or driver. So the examples are CMOS 4511. So it is a driver which is known as a binary coded decimal of BCD to 7-segment display decoder, and it is able to illuminate both the common anode type and the common cathode type. So there is some multiplexing involved to reduce the number of input output pins. So what actually happens is each anode of the segment is connected together and to the driver circuit pin, and all the cathodes of all the segments of each digit are connected. So to light up a particular segment, let's say this segment, first this digit is chosen and then the A segment is chosen across all, because they're all connected together. So this particular segment lights up. So let's say we want to light up the number 0. We first choose a anode for this digit And then the cathode for all these A, B, C, D, E, and F segments. So the number 0 lights up. Supposing we want a multiple digit display, like this for example, this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 digits. What we need to do is, first this digit is chosen, the number 0 is displayed. Then after some time, this is chosen, then the number 1 is displayed, because we can't have both running at the same time. Then this is chosen, and this process is done so fast that due to the persistence of vision, we can see all of them being lit up at the same time. We cannot, the human eye cannot decipher what is, which digit is being lit up at which time. So we see all of them being lit up at the same time. Okay, so the next part will be me explaining the exact code involved in the 7 segment display and how we interfaced it to the 8085 module. So the first couple of lines is just loading the values in the accumulator and specifying the output ports. Okay, so the next part is initializing the counters. So there are two counters here. One is a bit counter and one is a character counter. So the bit counter has a value equal to 08 because there are 8 bits or 8 LEDs, that is a 7 segments and 1 decimal point. And the character counter is set to 04 here because it's a 4 digit display and we want to display 4 characters. So what exactly happens is, first the clock is set to low here and then the loop starts. So what happens in the loop is the character counter's value keeps on decreasing by 1, and even the bit counter keeps on decreasing by 1, and it specifies whether that port is to be high or low. And this part just checks whether the character is not 0 and it continues looping. Okay, so this way, using two loops, first one loop for each digit, that's a bit counter, and the loop for each character, that is a character counter. Once we are done with that, the display comes on. So this part of the code is specifically about the digits or the letters we want displayed. So for a 4-digit display, we need to display 1, 2, 3, 4 hexadecimal numbers. Now if we translate these numbers into binary, you'll see it's a pattern 1011 1010001. So this actually corresponds to the exact LEDs in a specific manner of rotation. So similarly, we can write the code for any permutation and combination of LEDs being lit in the 7 segment. So for example, this specific code enters a value, enters a word good. This we performed in the class and you can see that the word good is entered. Now similarly, we found out the values corresponding to other letters, and we changed the character counter over here to 09. We wanted to print a 9 letter word, beautiful for example. The bit counter will remain the same because there are still 8 bits involved. So we changed the value to 9 and we directly entered 9 values here. We kept on entering more values. So I'll just show you what it looked like. So here we go. So as you can see, we printed the word peripheral on the module. So that's pretty much how the code works and how you can use it to print any word. And remember, the persistence of vision allows us to display any amount of digits. Let's move on to the applications of the 7 segment display. So it's basically used in, it's a display device, so it's used to display electronic devices. It's used in calculators and it's used in microwave oven displays and other electronic displays. It's also used in digital clocks, odometers, clock radios, etc. So mostly nowadays the 7 segment applications are using the LCD modules. So each individual segment is made up of an LCD instead of an LED, because the power consumption in such modules is lesser. Also, there are some mechanical modules available. If you would have seen in a petrol pump, there are mechanical 7 segment displays. So they have a rotating frame which rotates and accordingly the correct number is displayed. So I hope you gained an insight into the 7-segment display, and I hope you learned something from this presentation. Thank you.